welcome back to the Jason Peabody Project. You guys are amazing. And I have, like I said, I have the amazing Mike Simmons here with me today. Hey, Mike.
Hey, how's it going? Thank you for calling me the amazing Mike Simmons. I feel like a superhero, kind of like the amazing Spider-Man, the amazing Mike Simmons.
Well, are the amazing Mike Simmons. I just got finished telling everybody how you helped Jason and I up-level our life when we were in seven-figure flipping. Of course, everyone knows us now as the multifamily people, but we were once flipping and wholesaling. And yep. We've had you on the show, I think, a couple of times. We haven't talked for so long. I want to know what's happened in the last year. So give us the lowdown.
Yeah, a lot's happened. So a year ago, almost exactly a year ago, Bill Allen took over, seven-figure flipping, and I joined him in that journey and became a partner in the business. So that was pretty huge, kind of buying in and having ownership and kind of taking that on. That was really, really cool. I'm still flipping and wholesaling. Nothing has changed there. But also, I wrote a book, and that was a huge, huge chunk for me of big time and energy, and you know, a lot of planning went into it. So I wrote a book called Level Jumping. And it's basically, level jumping is my telling of how I went from just kind of being the small one person kind of an operation to growing a team and building a business that generated over $1 million in gross profits in a year. And I did it primarily, just not to give away the ending of the book, but primarily it was because I joined seven-figure flipping back, you know, a few years back. So it really changed my life, and I got to meet awesome people like Andy and Terry and mm-hmm. folks that you've had on the show. And through just kind of networking and masterminding and understanding what they're doing right and wrong in their businesses, we were able to grow. And I've been asked, like, because we had this silly little contest when seven-figure flipping started, who can get to $1 million first, and they get to go to Hawaii. And me and my partner, Mike, won. And so I get asked about that. Like, how did you do it? What did you do differently that allowed you to scale up so fast? And so I wrote the book to kind of outline exactly what we did. I get the question, so I thought a book might be kind of fun and a way for me to stop answering the question over and over and over again to people, so you can get the book.
So I actually want to dive into the story because it's such an amazing story, such a funny story, such an inspiring story. But folks, you're going to have to get that book. So I'm going to leave the link. I'm going to leave the link in the show notes. But just for our people, where can they find the book?
You can get it on Amazon, but I'll tell you what, Billy, for your audience, if it's cool with you, they can get a free digital version of the book if they would like. And if you want to get a free digital download of the book, you can text the words just start, two words now, just start, to the number 55444. So 55444, just start, I'll give you a free digital download. But if you want a physical copy, go to Amazon, buy it, and that's awesome too.
Well, either way, either text that number and just start at, or go to Amazon, look it up. It is Level Jumping by Mike Simmons. It is a fantastic book. So Mike, there's so much we can cover right now, I want, okay, if you had one huge bit of advice, especially if it's in the book, one huge bit of advice for anyone who is, because we've all been there. We've all been down in the dumps, we've been taken down either by our businesses or by the current events.
Yep.
What action steps, what bit of advice would you give my listeners who are in that area of their life right now?
Yeah. So I'll give you two, because there's two things that I have to say that are very important. The number one thing that I did, the one decision, the one move that I made that probably is responsible for a disproportional amount of the success that I've had over the last few years, was I had to get past my limiting belief that I did not have a big enough company to start hiring people. Now, hiring doesn't mean go out and be irresponsible and hire 10 people when you really can't afford it. But I thought I couldn't hire anybody, which was a real limiting belief, because I had this circular logic going and it was really deflating. It was like, I want to be a bigger company. I want to have more revenue. I want to have more profits, but I can't do it alone. So I need to hire someone, but I can't hire someone because I'm not a big enough company, but I'll never be a big enough company until I hire. So it's like this crazy, like, vortex you get sucked into. And what I learned was you can hire responsibly and slowly and hire for need and kind of build that team slowly. And that's how you can do it. And I learned that, and this is the second piece of advice, is by joining a mastermind that was full of people that had more knowledge than me, smarter than me, had already figured a lot of things out that I haven't figured out yet. And by surrounding myself with those people, I got this kind of wisdom from them and the Andys of the world, who Andy gets credit for, like, he's like top of the tree of success for seven-figure flipping. But it's true, he's a super smart guy and he's done a lot of great things in business. And he showed me how I can do it. And so by hiring people that were, by the way, better than me at whatever it was that I was hiring for. So for example, one of the first people I hired was a salesperson, because sales isn't my superpower. I'm okay, like I can do it if I have to, but that's not what you want in a salesperson, someone who does it if they have to. You want someone who goes, yes, I'm a salesperson and I wanna get in there and I wanna talk to homeowners and I wanna help them with their problems. Like, you need someone like that. When I hired someone like that, my sales like doubled and tripled almost immediately, because they were really good and I wasn't having the success they had because I didn't love it. Matter of fact, I dreaded it kind of. And it's not because I don't want to help people. I'm just not a salesperson at heart, right? I'm a little bit more introverted. So getting a salesperson who's really, really great, not only increased revenue, but it also increased cash flow. So I had the ability to go out and now continue to build that team. So hiring people, like, you'll always get farther with a team than you will alone, always. And if that team is full, and if you have like your ego in check where you can hire people that are actually better than you and they can really like take it to the next level that you couldn't have, the possibilities are endless. So that's the one thing I would say.
And I love the thought of team and mentorship. So let's dig into that. So yeah. Seven-figure flipping, seven-figure attitude, seven-figure everything, and flip hacking live. Tell me all about what's happening with flip hacking live.
Yeah, so flip hack. So here's the thing, guys. If you're listening to this and you're like, oh wow, that mastermind sounds great. Well, listen, it's a closed mastermind. It's only for members. We sit around a couple, like four times a year. We have meetings and we exchange ideas, high level thinkers, high level ideas, like real big difference makers in our businesses. And we're all kind of growing and succeeding through that. And if you're like, wow, I want to do that. Well, there's a barrier to entry. There's a cost to get in the mastermind. It's not cheap. It's pretty expensive actually, but relative to our industry and the kind of revenue and profits that you can be made, it's really not that expensive, but there is a cost, right? And if you're like, well, I don't have, you know, thousands of dollars to spend on a mastermind, here's the good news. Once a year, that mastermind opens up its discussions, opens up its knowledge, opens up everything it knows and presents it to the public for like a couple of $100s, like super cheap tickets for 3 days. You get primarily some of the best and brightest investors from around the country who are part of our mastermind, who typically will only answer questions for me and other people in the mastermind. They'll be on stage presenting what they're great at, the things that have made them successful in their business. They will present it for virtually free, a couple $100. And you can get this for 3 days. You don't have to be part of the mastermind to get this. You can just go. This year it's gonna be virtual, so there's no plane tickets, there's no hotel rooms, there's no eating out. Like, it used to be like the cost of the tickets were like $1,000 at the day of the event, plus another few thousand dollars for travel and for food. Like, it was a $2,000 to $4,000 proposition. This year, for a couple $100, you can get all of it. It's all virtual. It's a dozen investors presenting from stage. And by the way, these presenters, they're not like circuit speakers where like they go around to things and they're just like, everyone on stage had something to sell and they only give you a little flavor of what they know because they're trying to reel you in. No, these are like investors. And most, you know, Peely, you've been a part of this for a long time. Most of these people, pretty much all of them, are not presenters. So A, they're a little bit rough around the edges when it comes to presenting. And B, they have nothing to sell. They have no agenda. And their only mandate from like Bill and me and folks who run this is just give it all away. Like, just give it all. Like, whatever you're gonna present from A to Z, give it to the folks so they can implement this when they leave. And so it's just a bunch of people who don't have an agenda. So they're just giving it all away. They don't know any better, right? And they're not like great presenters. So, you know, sometimes presenters are real good at like giving you a sense, but not really giving away the farm. These guys don't know to do that. They don't know anything about presenting. So they just give everything away, and me included, right? Like, we've had our meetings the day before Flip Hacking Live, and I'll learn something the day before Flip Hacking Live, and I've put it in my presentation. And I've even had people come up and go, I can't believe you said that in front of everybody. Like, we literally just talked about this yesterday in a private closed environment, and you just spilled it on stage. But that's what we all do. It's a very giving 3 days full of knowledge and just great people.
This is why I love this group. It is, I mean, seriously, folks, Flip Hacking Live changed our life. This is how we joined Seven Figure Flipping. This is how we jumped in. Because during these 3 days, Mike says it, they give it all away. And yes, I will reiterate, I do not flip anymore. I am totally multifamily. But how do you think I learned how to do all the things that I know how to do? How do you think Jason does everything that he does? It's because of this group. Had we not found this group, yeah, maybe we could be where we are today, but I don't really think so. This group, I mean, you hear people talk about mentorship and how mentors will up-level your life. This is the group that did that for Jason and I. And so let it be the group, the conference that does it for you, that takes you to the next level.
Yep.
So I'm gonna leave that link below. Click on that link, go to Flip Hacking Live, sign up.
Julie, if I could say one more thing about Flip Hacking Live is, here's the deal, guys. Even if you're like, you know, I'm doing pretty good. My business is kind of where I want it to be. Like, I think I have it figured out. Here's the deal. I started in 2008, my business originally, right? That was when everything was crashed, like real estate was burning and people were screaming, you know, house prices were like in the gutter. I don't know what's gonna happen in the next 12 months, but I have yet, and I talk to a lot of people around the country who have been doing this a long time, who I value their opinions very, very much. And I have yet to find one who doesn't agree that we are in for something soon. There's going to be a downturn. You can debate all day long how bad it will be, how long it will last, what the reason for it is, but I have yet to find anyone who says we are stable and good for the foreseeable future. Things are changing, and we're going to talk about that this year. That's going to be a focus of Flip Hacking Live. What are we doing to prepare for that? And how do we maximize our potential over the next 12 to 18 months? My talk specifically, what I'm going to present on is what I wish I could go back and tell 2008 Mike Simmons. Like, what would I tell that guy so that he could better take advantage of the situation he was in at the time? He didn't know anything, right? He was new. So what would I do differently? What would I tell myself? Those are the kind of advice that's the kind of advice people need right now for what we're about to enter.
Mike, thank you so much for coming back on. It's been so good talking with you. And same. Folks, listeners, guys, you get to talk to Mike if you join this conference. You get to listen to him speak. You get to listen to all the goodness that he's learned from 2008 up to now. And he gives it all away. This is when you can ask your questions, get some answers, and really dive in. And if you already know about the Seven Figure Flipping team, and you're on the fence trying to think about if you're going to join or if you're not going to join, this is the perfect opportunity for you to test the waters with this group. And it is a great and amazing group. So Mike, thank you so very much for coming on. If people are looking to get a hold of you, to ask you some questions, or just to get to know you a little bit more, how can they find you?
Yeah, for sure. I have a podcast called Just Start Real Estate, right? Hence the Just Start thing and the texting there. If you're interested in Flip Hacking Live, definitely go check that out. I'm available through that too, but you can also email me at mike@juststartrealestate.com. If you have any questions, concerns, comments, I'm happy to talk to you. If you have questions about Flip Hacking Live, I can answer those too.
Fantastic. Thank you again so much, Mike. So grateful.
Thanks. Good to see you again. This is awesome.
Good to see you. And for all my listeners, I'm grateful to you for listening. You are amazing. Now go check out that link. Bye now.
Bye-bye.
Join us for your second cup of coffee every Monday through Friday at noon.
Live every day, bringing us our best content we've done so far. Super excited, super engaging, bunch of great guests. We're here to answer your questions, and we so appreciate you listening. Make sure to check us out.
Can't wait to see you.